Hi, we're at the PC-DMIS Touch booth with Eric Hollenbeck, who's going to tell us about a brand new product from Hexagon, the PC-DMIS Touch. Eric, tell us a little bit about this product and how it got started and what it's all about.
Yep, it's been developed for about 6-8 months, and we really see an opening in the market, and it's something that we really think we can hit a big home run with.
In a nutshell, what is it?
It is a touch version of PC-DMIS. It's a user interface, which is much easier and interactive for the user so that they can learn quicker and become more effective at the job.
So really, this is basically an easier way to to program and run programs on some of your equipment, is that right?
That's absolutely correct, yes. Right now we're doing it for the arms only, but we anticipate down the road it'll be the interface of choice for all of our metrology equipment. But just as we see PC-DMIS as being a common software, this will be the common interface for PC-DMIS. With it running in the background with all the power of computation and all the processing that goes along with PC-DMIS.
Okay, well run us through it and show us what it does.
Okay, here we go. So this is the opening screen. As you can see, it's just touch. I just hit that. This is a touchscreen monitor. I've got a little Lenovo laptop over there as well. So we just start off. We just hit, you don't have to think too much. You just look around. It's like, yep, new, yeah, I want to do a new program. So I'm going to give it a name. And we'll call it quality.
So right now we're setting up for a new program, is that right?
That's correct. Just as if I just walked up, my boss says I got to write a program. I got to get this part inspected. It's got to be done right now. You can't wait around. Let's get the job done, right? So we're in America. I'll come over here. And if I was going to take a picture of this part, I'd just bring my laptop over.
Okay, so you just took a picture of the part, what, just for documentation purposes?
Yep, just so for documentation and for my operator. If you look back here on the screen, we've got a picture of the part right there. You can say done. And now if I go back up to the original screen, there's my quality digest part. So I could have kept going with the program, but just to show you what's going to happen with that. So then, you know, everybody talks about alignments with parts and how difficult alignments can be. Well, here's alignment with touch. Measure a plane. Done.
So that was just a plane measurement you did right there.
Just the plane for level and the Z origin. Now I just did a line, that's going to give me my rotation. And finally, another line to complete my alignment. Now this is an alignment. Done. It's that easy.
So it took about 45 seconds.
Exactly. And we're used to the old ways where you have to measure the features and then go through the selections, and we've just canned everything up to make it super easy.
Okay. So now that's actually our program now for a very simple program. And so now you're ready to run this?
Yeah. Let's say if I wanted to do a few more things. Like, let's say, measure a couple circles. There's a circle, and let's say we measure one more.
Now, I noticed that automatic determined, you didn't tell it that you were going to do a circle, right? It automatically determined that it was a circle.
Yeah, and I'll do one more circle, and because I want you to see something. So I'm going to measure 4 points on the center bore. Now look at, on the right side of the screen, this is one of the latest features with touch. Notice how it measured 4 points, and in classic PC-DMIS, if you measure 4 points, it's going to guess. We call it feature recognition. It's been around for a few years. But what you don't know is what it's going to guess. So it guesses something, and it inserts that feature into your program. And if it's what you wanted, great, you win. If it's not what you wanted, then you got to back out and go through a few menu steps to get exactly what you wanted. And if, in this case, if it was a circle, then you'd have to force it to be a circle. Now what we've got it highlights what it thinks you wanted to, what you think you wanted to create. And in this case, it thinks I want to do an inside circle. But since that's four hits, it could also be an outside circle, geometrically, of course, not. And then it could also be a plane, of course, and it could also be a line. So it's giving me and also a sphere over here. So it gives me the options. If I want to say, no, it's a sphere, I just touch sphere. Now it's going to say that it's going to create a sphere from those four points.
Okay, so again, a very simplified interface and more intuitive, actually.
Much more intuitive, exactly. Just what the user needs to see and nothing else, just the simple stuff. Oh. So it says circle, and I'm going to say, yeah, that's what I want. Circle, done. So now I got all the features, I got my program. Let's say I want to do some dimensions from that circle. Let's say that circle. It's going to give me the measured distance. Nice thing is right here, I can substitute the nominal. If I know that this is supposed to be 32.3, I know the tolerances are supposed to be 0.005. 5 thou. I'll have the information here. I can say done. Let's say I also would like to do a concentricity of these two circles. Gives me the measured value here. I can edit the tolerance. We'll say 8 thou for that guy. And say done. Save my program. I got my report. This is what I will end up with. And then I can go into my run screen. So now I have a full program that's been completely written. It's ready to inspect the part. Bring in my operator. Say, okay, Mr. Operator, need you to run this part. You want to run from top? Yes, I do. I want to run the whole thing, including the alignment. Prompts me to go right through it. Starts off with the plane, gives me a nice graphical representation over here. If the operator is unsure, you can drag it around, you can rotate it, have a quick look. What's feature is which and where is it? So first thing I'm going to do is measure the plane. That's what my guy told me. There we go. 1, 2. And I measure my line. Now I go into my circles.
And obviously all the way along the way it's prompting you for what dimension you're going to be taking.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. If we look over on the screen here, it's telling me that this circle, this particular circle is used in two dimensions, in the distance, first distance dimension that I did, and also in the concentricity dimension. It gives me that it's not necessarily necessary for the operator, but it gives him a little bit of buy-in. It makes him part of the process and understand what's going on. So then I go back to my report. So I've got my report, and it's all the features that I measured, all the dimensions, the tolerances that I set. I can say save, and then I can go preview. I can export the program. I can print the program. And just for posterity, there's my report along with my program. We're rolling it out just to get, it's our big show. We gotta show it, but it's ready. It's working great. We love it, and we can't wait to see our customers using it.
All right, that was Eric Hollenbeck showing us the PC-DMIS Touch. Eric, thanks a lot.
Appreciate it, Dirk.
Sure, no problem. Sure. Well,